Hello, dear friends and colleagues. Today I'd like to talk about another important topic. It is polyarthritis nodosa. Again, it is very important because you will get this case in MRCP part 1, part 2, and event spaces. So, polyarthritis nodosa, poly means multiple, you know. Arthritis, that means inflammation of the artery. Basically, it is multiple vasculitis. So, the name polyarthritis nodosa implies that there is vasculitis in multiple area in the body. So another thing actually we have to remember that P for poly, again A for answer, N for no. So in polyarthritis nodosa there are multiple answer will be no. I'll be discussing that one afterward. Before that, I'm just starting basic. Polyarthritis nodosa is an autoimmune disease. It is already I mentioned that it is a vasculitic disease, so there will be vasculitis, and vessel will be medium size. Small size you can say also, medium to small size. You know that all autoimmune disease, most of the autoimmune disease, female are more affected. What about this one? Here, this is exceptional, male are more affected. Male is to female 3:1. Another disease also male are more affected, that is ankylosing spondylitis, and this one polyarthritis nodosa, male predominant. Okay, now as it is vasculitis, there will be inflammations of the medium and small size of vessel of the body, and due to inflammation you know that there will be soiling of the wall of the vessel, which lead to narrowing of the vessel. Ultimately there will be less blood supply to the organ, that means ischemia. This ischemia actually lead to all the sign symptoms, and I will discuss organ by organ. Okay, another change will occurs in the vessel, there will be microaneurysm. So microaneurysm is another features of vasculitis in case of polyarthritis nodosa. Okay, now which organ usually affected by this polyarthritis nodosa, that is vasculitis? First skin, second muscle, then third one joint, GI tract, kidney, testis, brain, heart. But remember it, it will never involve lungs. If you find any involvement or any symptoms of lungs, that is cough, hemoptysis, it is not polyarthritis nodosa, rather it could be another vasculitic disease like Wegener granulomatosis, polyangiitis, microscopic polyangiitis, like that. So not polyarteritis. So now, as there is vasculitis in the skin, you will find some rashes in the skin because the vessel will be prominent due to inflammation. So you will find livido reticularis, one of the diagnostic criteria. Second one, muscle. If there is ischemia muscle, there will be muscular pain, so myalgia. In joint, similar mechanism, there will be arthralgia. In gastrointestinal tract, you will find ischemia of the gut, so this will lead abdominal pain. In the kidney, there will be ischemia, so renal function will be impaired. There will be hematuria, and as renal function involved impaired, you will get hypertension. So if diastolic blood pressure more than 90, it is one of the diagnostic criteria of polyarteritis nodosa. Okay, now testicular pain. In testes, there will be testicular pain because there is ischemia, blood supply, less blood supply. So it is the prototype symptoms of polyarteritis nodosa. Any male complain of orchitis, you have to think about, if there is any vasculitis, you have to think about polyarteritis nodosa. So it can involve heart. What will happen? Ischemia. So that means it is one of the cause of myocardial infarction. If involve brain, that means stroke, ischemia of the brain. Okay, so if I summarize the symptoms according to the involvement, in brain there will be stroke, in heart there will be myocardial infarction, in gastrointestinal tract there will be pain in the abdomen, in kidney there will be renal impairment, hematuria, in skin there will be livido reticularis, and muscle there will be myalgia, and joint there will be arthralgia, testis there will be testicular pain. Just remember that it is male predominant disease, male is to female is more, so male can present with orchitis. Okay, now there are some diagnostic criteria. Patient will lose weight around 4 kilogram in from the starting of the disease. So 4 kilogram weight loss, one of the diagnostic criteria. So just summarize the diagnostic criteria. Reduce weight 4 kilogram, skin livido reticularis, then myalgia, arthralgia, another one testicular pain, then renal involvement. So this type of symptoms what I discuss, patient will get. So out of 10 criteria, other criteria actually I mentioned that diastolic blood pressure will be more than 90, and creatinine and urea level will be high because of renal involvement. Patient will be associated with hepatitis B virus, so it is one of the criteria. There will be some changes in renal angiogram, that means there will be aneurysm, and if we do biopsy of the vessel, we'll find necrotizing inflammation, predominantly polymorphonuclear necrocytosis will be there, infiltration of the polymorpholipocyte. So these 10 criteria, again remember, weight reduction 4 kilogram, libido reticularis, mild arthralgia fatigue, then testicular pain, mononeuritis multiplex, diabetes, diastolic blood pressure more than 90, you'll find hepatitis B association, urea creatinine high, arteriography C, microaneurysm, and biopsy, polyarteritis, nodosa will get, polymer polynuclear leukocyte infiltration, and necrotizing inflammations of the blood vessel. This out of 10, if anybody has 3 criteria, we can say that this patient is having polyarteritis nodosa. Okay, so that is it. Now I'd like to say some no. Poly means multiple, again I say multiple, answer will be no. A for answer and no, N for no. So what is the no? One no, ANCA negative. ANCA, that is ANCA, anti-neutrophil and cytoplasmic antibody will be negative. Though other vasculitis like Eisner granulomatosis and microscopic polyangiitis, ANCA will be positive. Polyarteritis nodosa, there will be no positive ANCA. Okay. Number 2, it will not involve lung. Number 3, there will be hematuria, but there will be no cast cell in the urine. That means there will be no glomerulonephritis. If glomerulonephritis and if cast cell, then you have to think about another vasculitic disease, again like Eisner granulomatosis or microscopic polyangiitis. So if you do urine test, it is very simple test to differentiate between polyarteritis nodosa and other vasculitis like Eisner granulomatosis. Okay. Another option, there is no granuloma. Granuloma is present in the Eisner granulomatosis, not in polyarteritis nodosa. Okay. And there will be no involvement of capillary, arterioles, venules. And last, there is no cure, unfortunately. So there are certain no. One is no ANCA, no granuloma, no lungs involvement, no cast, no RBC cast, no glomerulonephritis, no capillary venule or arterial involvement, and no cure. Just remember it. From this 6 no, you can get some question. So what will be the diagnostic test? Just do ANCA, it will be negative. Then do urine RE, where you will get hematuria, RBC in the urine, but will not get cast cell. Go for renal angiography, you will find microaneurysm. Then you will go for biopsy, you will find necrotizing vasculitis with neutrophilic infiltration, and other test according to the organ involvement. What will be the treatment? Treatment will be steroid. If steroid not response, go for cyclophosphamide or azathioprine or methotrexate. If not respond, then go for biological agent like rituximab. These are the treatment and assurance of the patient. Now 30% patient may have hepatitis B virus infection. So sometimes people say that it is actually antigen antibody complex depositions in the blood vessel, that is type 3 reaction, can cause the polyarthritis nodosa. Okay, so any patient if give history of vasculitis or symptoms of vasculitis, vasculitis symptoms means fatigue, fever, myalgia, arthralgia, hemisuria, this type of symptoms, normal movement, polyneuritis multiplex, mononeuritis multiplex, polyneuritis. So this type of symptoms of vasculitis and give history of hepatitis B positive, HBsAg positive, and prototype orchitis, tenderness of testis, male patient, young patient. Sometimes they give history of myocardial infarction and stroke in the young age. So you have to think polyarthritis nodosa. Question may come like this: whether polyarthritis nodosa is ANCA positive or negative? Your answer will be negative. Whether polyarthritis nodosa can cause glomerulonephritis or not? Your answer will be no, it is not involved. How will differentiate whether by simple test from other vasculitis like Wiesner gallinomatosis and polyarthritis nodosa? By doing urine RE, will not get RBC cast, only get hematuria. What is the prototype symptoms? Involvement of the testis, that is tenderness of the testis, orchitis, ischemia of the testis, basically pain in the testis. This is a prototype symptoms in polyarthritis nodosa. So if I summarize, polyarthritis nodosa is a vasculitis of medium vessels. There are some nose and there are some criteria, diagnostic criteria. It is due to the narrowing of the blood vessel, symptoms developed, and also you will get aneurysm of the blood vessel. It will never involve lungs. Young is involved brain, myocardial infarction, polyarthritis nodosa. Hopefully you'll be able to answer all the questions related to the polyarthritis nodosa. Thank you very much. For getting more videos similar, just subscribe my channel. I'll be uploading another video very soon. Thank you very much.